Adama Barrow, 227,708 votes. For myself, 208,486 votes. I hereby reject the results in totality. Let me repeat. I will not accept the results based on what has happened.
Gambia Society was started in the aftermath of the December 1st elections. We voted for a change, and the ex-president was trying to silence us like he did for 22 years, and we said no.
The campaign really started on Facebook. We decided to change our profile pictures to say hashtag Gambia has decided. And overnight, you know, everywhere that you looked on our friends list, you had everyone having the same profile picture.
Everyone had taken ownership of the hashtag, and it was no longer a group thing, but a national movement.
I hereby declare a state of public emergency throughout the Islamic Republic of the Gambia.
All of us took a risk, and we knew what we were taking, the risk we were taking. I remember the first day we met, I told them, anybody who's afraid to die or go to jail can just walk out. But we said, whoever's in trouble, all of us will come together.
As a family, it was a bit difficult because at some point when they started arresting people for wearing the t-shirts, I had to go and live in my mom's house with my son.
At the time, we had to be really careful because we were still printing t-shirts, but we had to move them very carefully. It was as if we were moving, you know, illegal drugs or something.
But at the time, we had no sense of fear. I mean, we were erecting billboards in the middle, in strategic places in Gambia, whilst Jammeh was in power with the soldiers.
But we were still distributing. I remember having to drive all the way to Brikama because I had people there who were asking for these t-shirts, and we just had to do it. Luckily for us, no one, you know, no one knew or understood what we were carrying.
At that point, it became increasingly dangerous because they were just going around putting out all our billboards, and they were really going to get us.
The graffiti started popping up on walls, on the roads, and it was beautiful because they couldn't go around and paint over that graffiti. Looking at this, it just really shows how this happened because we couldn't do this. We were not allowed to wear our t-shirts. We were not allowed to put up billboards. And it's beautiful that now we're able to stand here, walk around with our shirts, and not be scared that when we get home tonight, we would be picked up.
My advice to human rights defenders, you need to really believe in what you're doing. That helped us to keep going when it really got tough.
And get as many people behind you as possible and use one voice to speak, then you can be powerful and really cross any obstacle that you're facing.
It's everywhere, it belongs to everybody, and that is what we wanted. We want everybody to speak and to speak powerfully, and that message is very clear, and I think it has left an indelible memory in the history of Gambia and Africa, and I think one of the most beautiful moments ever in the history of mankind.